Farms.com Market School with expert commodity analyst Mo Agostino is an online educational video series designed to help you, the farmer, improve your knowledge of grain marketing. Farms.com Market School is brought to you by DeKalb Brand Seeds. DeKalb, growing confidence.
Welcome back. In today's video, we're going to continue with our implementation, developing that marketing plan. But in this video, we're going to use farm examples. We're going to compare farm A to farm B when we go through those five steps we talked about in our last video. Our first topic is to review the five steps in implementing that marketing plan. So here's those five steps again from the last video. Number one, determine your objective. To manage that risk and volatility, has to be precise. Determine your trading strategy, the instruments you're going to use in order to trigger that marketing plan, determine who's going to execute the strategy, determine the frequency that the plan will be reviewed, and then finally determine the role of the third party, whether it's the broker, the banker, or both. Our second topic today is comparing that farm A versus farm B. So they're going to have different financial structures, and we're going to go through a bunch of questions that you need to ask as we go through the five steps. So there are different considerations for different financial structures. So again, farm A, we're assuming, has a cost production of $350 a bushel, no debt. Farm B has a cost production of $350 a bushel, operating costs, fixed and variable, with debt servicing costs of about 50 cents a bushel. So they're highly levered. So one's no debt, one's highly levered. So let's go through a bunch of examples. Farm A can accept more risk, farm B cannot. So when we're talking about determining your objectives, these are the types of questions that Farm A would ask or do versus Farm B. Should not be evaluated on gains or losses in futures or options. Should be specific and measurable. For example, to lock in a particular profit or price, to maximize revenue or minimize cost, to protect against a disaster, to lock in a minimum price and protect against a disaster. Should be affected by risk position of the farm, especially when prices are too low to cover costs. So, for example, farm A and B can lock in $4.20 per bushel. Farm A possible objectives include obtain the highest price of the season, protect against the downside risk while retaining the opportunity for upside movement, or a combination of the above. Farm B, possible objectives include lock in all or a major part of the expected production at the current price, but provide for a possibility of upside potential. If they can lock in 480, then Farm B can protect the downside for the entire expected crop and follow a scale-up approach if prices continue to rise. Lock in a fixed price for a portion of the crop sufficient to cover cost production and debt service expense and attempt to obtain the highest price for the remainder of the year. Determine your trading strategy. Your trading strategy generally follows the objective. Determine your trading plan, what instrument, what triggers a trade, what you are going to do about emerging risks or opportunities. Farm A can obtain the highest price of the season, protect against downside risk while retaining the opportunity for upside movement, a combination of the foregoing or scale-up approach. Farm B, lock in all or major part of the expected production at the current price, but provide for a possibility of upside potential, protect the downside for the entire expected crop, and follow a scale-up approach if prices continue to rise. Or lock in a fixed price for a portion of the crop and attempt to obtain the highest price for the remainder of the season. Three, determine who will execute the strategy. Step three, will a single individual be delegated authority to execute trades? Will a committee be struck? If the latter, if you do have a committee, how will decisions be made, especially when there is disagreement? Step four, determine how the plan will be reviewed. Needs to be reviewed to determine whether it still captures the needs of the business. Need to assess how well the plan execution is operating relative to the plan itself. Review no more frequently than once per quarter. Could be your objective, or it could be once a week. Markets have been moving a little bit more up and down in the last 7 years, so maybe that has to be a little bit more frequent because you may miss out on opportunities. Step five, determine the role of the third party. The role of the commodity broker should be limited to understanding and perhaps assisting in the development of the plan, providing information on any technical features used to trigger in futures, options, our forward contracts, filling orders promptly, providing accurate and timely position records. We've discussed this in our video on how to deal with a commodity broker. The role of the finance partner should include understanding the plan, providing an electronic or other agreed transfer of funds when required by the plan to maybe help fund the hedge account. So in summary, having a risk management or marketing plan is very important to helping you manage through that increased risk and volatility. Execution of the plan is even more important. Know those steps again, use less emotion, and stay disciplined.